So let's take one example and see how it works when we substitute the variables with actual numbers. So let's take an example Z1 with components 3 plus 2i and Z2, also another complex number with the component 2 minus i. So we want to find their division. So we divide Z1 by Z2, which gives us the division of their components this way. So we can divide if and only if we multiply both the numerator and the denominator by the conjugate of what the denominator. Since the imaginary number here is negative, we have to change the sign toward positive to get its conjugate complex number. So 2 plus i, so that we can cancel, meaning we are just introducing 1. So we expand and simplify. So expanding this, we are going to get 6 plus 3i plus 4i plus 2i squared all over 2 squared plus 1 squared, which also gives us a simplification of 4 plus 7i all over 5. So this is our final answer when we divide these two complex numbers Z1 and Z2. To end today's lesson, let's see how we can represent such forms of complex numbers on what we call the complex plane or a number plane, which consists of complex numbers. The complex plane. Assuming we have a Cartesian plane with a vertical axis and horizontal axis. If it were a normal Cartesian plane, we label this y axis and this as x axis. But for complex numbers, we label the vertical axis as the imaginary axis and the horizontal as the real axis. So we plot the imaginary aspect against the real world aspect of the complex number. Now let's try to plot Z1 and Z2 that we have here on the complex plane. Now for Z1, we ask ourselves, what's the real aspect? The real aspect is 3, so we demarcate positive 3. This is the origin on the real axis. So we have our 3 here, and the imaginary part is 2i. So we move 2 units along the imaginary axis. So we have 2i here. So we can trace and see where these two parts meet. So they eventually meet here. So we trace it to the word origin. So this line becomes Z1. Okay, so we name this Z1, it is equal to 3 plus 2i. Let's try this also, Z2. 2 minus i. So we locate 2 on the row axis and minus i. That's 1 unit below the vertical axis. So both of them meet here. So this line is the z to which is 2 minus I. And others can also be plotted on the same graph. So likely I'll give you some 2 complex numbers and try your hands on it, trying to plot them on the complex plane, and it will be very interesting. So let's see the first one we have to plot on the complex plane. We have z3 which is equal to negative 3 minus 2i, and the second one we have to plot is z4 which is minus 2 plus I. Try to plot this in addition to that as your take home assignment. We will be ending today's lesson here. So meet again. It's a goodbye.